So if you ever watch like a tragedy take place, like a car accident in front of like a four-year-old, right? What you'll notice is what they do is they spin around and stare at their parents.
What's up, guys? Jeff and Jeremy here. Another episode of 5 Minute Fatherhood. Fun question for today. I think we got this from our Joey in our 5 Minute Fatherhood group. And that was basically, should we shield young children from our stress? Or another way he kind of put it was, how or to what extent do we cushion our children from the demands placed upon us as adults while still including them as part of the family team on mission? I suppose it's important to preserve their childhood without the burdens of adulthood, but I also don't want to shield them to the point of destroying that family team element. I love this question because I think it's actually a really, really, really good question. I actually believe there's some things that we should include kids on earlier. I think so many times we shield them too much, or we pretend like the real world is not the real world, right? I know that might sound weird, but our philosophy is, we have toddlers and we're already talking about things like death, right? And we're already talking about things like some other things because they're out there and they're probably thinking about them already because it's like they see it every day, right? I mean, little bugs die that they see in this and that, like, but you have to, but it's okay to be appropriate. So another way I like to say it is we kind of tend to mirror our kids, meaning we like to be honest and real with them from day one, but we tend to mirror how their intensity of asking. So if it's a four-year-old inquisitively just like, oh, that's interesting, what's that? Then I'll maybe give a couple sentences back with almost that same kind of tone, right? But if it's a 15-year-old, asking like, the philosophical nature of death and all these things, that might be an hour conversation that's more serious. So like, I just think you have to kind of match their tone. It's been really, that's a helpful rule for us. But yeah, I don't know. I'd love to, we're still in the young stage, so I don't know how that progresses. But yeah, and I definitely think stress is a good way to put it. I think be really careful that you're not wanting to put stress or burden on them. You're wanting to inform them as resilient disciples of Jesus. And so those are two different things. How would you kind of say that, Jeremy?
Yeah, it's important to understand, you guys, that children, they don't know what any of this stuff means. So if you ever watch like a tragedy take place, like a car accident in front of like a four-year-old, right? What you'll notice is what they do is they spin around and stare at their parents, especially their father. And man, if they see you freaking out, if you're on an airplane and you're scared to death, and like they feed off of your faith or off of your stress. And so a lot of this is if you're really trusting the Lord and you're going through a really challenging season, then it's important for you. You can bring your children into that because you can also bring them into your faith or into your trust. Say, guys, we're having a really hard time paying the mortgage. We need more finances. Can you guys pray for us? Like, let's pray together as a family team. And, and then they see you release that and they don't know what it means like to have struggle with paying the mortgage.
Yeah.
What they know is like, what are you saying? And if you're panicking, they're panicking. Right. And what I would say is, you don't want your kids to be exposed to your panic. You want them to be exposed to your faith. And so if you're still wrestling through, you're the leader, right? So if you've ever been a part of a team and the leader gives up hope, the leader starts to panic, then we're all like freaking out. So I think that that's a much bigger variable than the age of the child. And so if you are responding appropriately and in trust, I think actually the younger, like Jeff is saying, like they're just going to learn that at a younger age. But man, if you're struggling and wrestling and you're sort of unloading your stress on your kids at a young age, that's not probably super healthy for them to try to absorb that. And their interpretation, they're just not spiritually prepared to figure out how to handle those things. And so I'd encourage you guys, like, treat your family like a team, go to them when you need help and support, but make sure that when you're having these conversations with your children, that they also see you model what it's like to go before the Father, cast your burdens on Him, letting that anxiety sort of bleed out of you as you build up your own trust and faith. And your kids are going to learn how to do that, and that's going to be really good equipping for them in the future.